Mount Calvary, I believe whatever the cost.
Well, good morning, everybody. How are my brothers and sisters this morning? Amen. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord this morning. Let's bow our heads and open up in prayer this morning. Dear Heavenly Father, Lord, we thank you for this wonderful place that you've given us, Lord. Lord, I just feel your spirit moving this morning, Lord. I feel the enthusiasm inside of this building. Lord, we came here to see you. We came here to get the message through our pastor directly from you, Lord. Lord, let that message resonate in our hearts. Let us share it with someone who may not know or anything about you, Lord. Lord, give each and every one of us the armor to stand up in your name at each and every turn. And in Jesus' precious name we pray. And all of God's people said, amen. Amen. Let's stand and sing this morning.
Thank you.
The Lord is my rock. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. And with that rock, we'll hold what? It'll hold the anchor, right? Be very sure that that rock will hold the anchor. I'm sure.
Amen.
Are you sure this morning that you're grounded in the rock of Jesus?
Amen.
Amen. Praise the Lord. Well, you guys, if we put our hands together, we got some special singing this morning. Let's see if we can get them up here.
Thank you.
Praise the Lord. Do we got some talent in this church or what?
Yeah.
All right. Wow. I know we have some talent in this church, and I can prove it. Yesterday, I was downstairs preparing, and these guys decide to come in. They're going to start practicing. And Bill got here before the singers got here, and Bill can rock them drums. He rocked this house with those drums right there. And it was just, it was good to hear. I mean, not only did I hear it downstairs, but I'm sure that neighbor and the next neighbor and that neighbor and the next neighbor down there heard it. Cindy was walking and she heard it. And she heard a joyous sound, so she came in to see what was going on. Amen? Amen. That's what we want to see. So there's a lot of talent in this church. And I appreciate each and every one of you. So let's stand up this morning. Everybody stand up. And with a big roaring cheer and a big old applause, let's get our pastor up here.
Amen. Amen. Thank the Lord for you this morning, for everybody to cheer, for being part of the service today. We're thankful for our visitors that cheer. Sister Dana's husband that cheer. David, right? David. Brother Bill. Sister Denise's son, daughter-in-law, and their grandkids. Robert, that's all I got.
That was impressive.
It was pretty good, wasn't it? I can't remember let me check my driver's license, see what my name is. No, we're thankful for everybody that's here today. Connie Shear hasn't been here in a little while. We haven't got to see her lovely face here. We're just thankful. Caleb that's here. Just thank for all. And I'll stand your name, all of you, if you want me to.
Okay.
We're glad for everybody.
Just
glad for everybody. I'm going to read this morning out of the book of Mark. If you have your Bibles and read with us, try to move along quickly. Mark chapter 5. I got several verses to read this morning. I think I read a lot of verses last week, and I read several again this week, so just pray that God will have his way in the message. Mark chapter number 5, beginning with verse number 1. The Bible says this: "And they came over unto the other side of the sea, into the country of the Gadarenes. And when he was come out of the ship, immediately there met him out of the tombs a man with an unclean spirit, who had his dwelling among the tombs, and no man could bind him, no, not with chains. Because he had been often bound with fetters and chains, and the chains had been plucked asunder by him, and the fetters broken in pieces, neither could any man tame him. And always night and day he was in the mountains and in the tombs, crying and cutting himself with stones. But when he saw Jesus afar off, he ran and worshipped him and cried with a loud voice and said, What have I to do with thee, Jesus, thou Son of the Most High God? I adjure thee by God that thou torment me not. For he said unto him, Come out of the man, thou unclean spirit. And he asked him, What is thy name? And he answered, saying, My name is Legion, for we are many. And he besought him much that he would not send them away out of the country. Now there was there, nigh unto the mountain, a great herd of swine feeding. And all the devils besought him, saying, Send us into the swine, that we may enter into them. And forthwith Jesus gave them leave, and the unclean spirits went out and entered into the swine, and the herd ran violently down a steep place into the sea. They were about 2,000 and were choked in the sea. And they that fed the swine fled and told it in the city and in the country, and they went out to see what it was that was done." And this is the verse I want you to take notice to this morning. "And they come to Jesus and see him that was possessed with the devil, and had the legion sitting and clothed and in his right mind, and they were afraid. Let's pray. Dear Lord, I thank you this morning for your presence here. Lord, thank you for everyone that's in attendance today. Lord, we ask for your favor upon us this morning as we reap the benefits, Lord, of enjoying the sanctuary, Lord, the presence of your Holy Spirit, Lord, the worship of the saints this morning as we sing praises unto you. And Lord, we call on your name, Lord, for guidance in our life. And Lord, we present the word this morning to hear it, Lord, to proclaim it, to put it up on our hearts, Lord, apply it to our lives, and Lord, help us to live by it today. Bless those that are less fortunate than we are. Pray that you'd give to them, Lord, according to your abundance today. Bless your servant here as I stand, Lord, before this congregation. Lord, give me the words to say that might encourage someone, Lord, that I might be able to help someone, Lord, through your spirit today. Lord, don't let me stand in the way of the message going forth, but Lord, you deliver it in the power and the demonstration of the Spirit. And Lord, I'll thank you and praise you for it all. For it's in Jesus' name I ask. And amen. Amen. All right, this morning, a familiar set of scriptures here in the book of Mark, chapter number 5. My thought this morning, out of verse number 15 that I read to you, is no chains needed. No chains needed. I want you to think about this man for just a minute and how we can use his story to benefit ourselves. Okay, every scripture, every story that we read, every historical aspect of this Bible that we read is meant for us today in some form. It's hard for us to sometimes relate to some of the stories in there, but there's a common thread this morning that ties us to this man that I read to you about. It's kind of not coincidence, but the way God presented his word here, just before this we read about the calming of the sea, you know, when they were out on the Sea of Galilee. And the Bible says that the boat began to rock from side to side, and they cried out to the Lord, aren't you going to save us? And the Bible says Jesus was asleep in the side of the ship, and he came up and said, where's your faith? And he spoke to the waters, and the waters was calmed. And immediately after this story that I read to you this morning, it talks about the woman with the issue of blood and how that the Lord healed her after many years of suffering with that disease. Well, as Jesus journeyed here, the Bible says that he came to this place where he found this man who was possessed. He actually had demons in him. And the Bible says that he lived in a graveyard among the tombs. And the people would try to bind him because they were afraid of what he might do. They were afraid of what he might do to them or do to himself. And the Bible says that as time went, he would break the chains loose. And in our reading this morning, it says that he would actually pick up stones and cut himself, harm himself because of this possession that he had. You say, how does that story of this man tie with my life? Well, as a believer in Jesus Christ this morning, I can say to you that there was a time in my life where that I was held captive to something that was destroying me. I wasn't possessed like the Exorcist, or my head didn't spin around and I didn't spit out green pea soup or anything like that. But I was possessed with sin, and it held me captive, and it kept me from being able to accomplish the things that God intended for me to do. I was in a place in my life that I longed to be rescued from, as this man was. I was unclothed with the righteousness of God. The Bible says that this man was naked, physically naked. I was also spiritually naked in the place that I was in without the Lord, unclothed with the righteousness of God. And here's the thing, I was looking for something better. You know, there's a lot of people today that don't believe in Christ, and they're looking for something better, not realizing that the best there is to offer is Jesus Christ and all that He has to give. I didn't even realize that until I accepted Him. But I was looking for something better. But for this man, as well as for me, and if you know the Lord as your Savior today, the Lord showed up. Amen. And the Bible says that, if you notice in our reading this morning, it said that when Jesus came, that this man ran to Him and worshiped Him. Even in the condition he was in, he ran to Him and he worshiped Him. And the Bible says that the Lord helped him to find. There's a song out that says, we have found a greater yes. This man found a greater yes in the Lord. And in our final verse that I read there, it says that when they came to where Jesus was and they saw this man who had been possessed with the devil, it says that they found him sitting. He was no longer running around like a madman. It says that he was clothed, he was no longer naked, and it says he was in his right mind, meaning that he knew what was going on around him. I believe he could say at this point in his life here, that verse 15 helps us to read this morning, that he would say there's no chains needed anymore. That's the way I am this morning. And if you know the Lord as your Savior today, if you're a believer in Jesus Christ, you can say that there's no chains needed. Yeah,
praise the Lord.
The Bible says, whom the Son sets free is free indeed. Jesus Christ, by His precious blood that He shed on Calvary, frees us from the bondage of sin and the captivity that the world holds upon us. We're free today. There's no chains needed. No longer do we see the things like we used to. No longer are we content with what we were, or even as believers in Christ, content with what we are. You see, we're seeking for a better country. We're seeking for something better than what this life has to offer. We have an eternal home in heaven that we're hoping and longing for. And we are looked at in a different way. We're looked at in a different way. You know, Christians today, people that are believers in Christ, true believers in Christ, people look at them as some type of crazy people, some type of lunatics, some type of freaks. We talked a little bit about it Thursday night in Bible study. We used to be called Jesus freaks. I don't know what they call us today. It doesn't matter because there's no chains needed. No chains needed. This morning I want to talk about, I got three points I want to make about this morning, because chains are not needed anymore. I got a couple more verses I want you to read. They're on the screen this morning, found in Psalm chapter 107, verse number 8. It says, "Oh, that men would praise the Lord for His goodness and for His wonderful works to the children of men. For He satisfieth the longing soul and filleth the hungry soul with goodness." And then in verse number 13, it says, "They cried unto the Lord in their trouble, and He saved them out of their distresses. He brought them out of darkness and the shadow of death, and brake their bands asunder." Oh, that men would praise the Lord for His goodness and for His wonderful works to the children of men. Let me say this morning, if you know Jesus Christ as your Savior today, there's absolutely no reason why you shouldn't praise Him today, because He set you free from the shackles that this world has upon you.
Amen.
And if you don't know Him today, you can easily be set free. Set free from what? They say, I've mentioned before, we have some verbiage as Christians that we use that the world doesn't understand. One of the words we use is to be saved. And I've heard people say, well, what are you saved from? What do you mean you're saved? What are you saved from? Brother, I'm saved this morning from the bondage of sin, number one. I'm saved from the eternal punishment that sin brings upon me. You see, because of man's disobedience in Adam's time all the way through till today, we are subjected to judgment by the words of this book. We talked about it on Thursday night. We're to be judged out of the words that this book says. And none of us in here can live up to what this book tells us to do. It's proven. The Bible says that God gave men the law so that He could prove to them that they could not live up to the righteousness of God. So what did He do? He didn't cause us to have to. He sent His only Son into the world to die on the cross so that our sin could be covered by His blood. And because our sins have been covered by His blood, when God looks upon me, He doesn't see me as an imperfect, unwilling, faulted creature, but He sees me as a child of God because the blood has been applied to my life. So I've been saved from eternal punishment. This morning, I've been saved. That's one of the words we use. I hope that you are. I hope you can walk away this morning saying that you have been saved. So what are we saved from? Some chains, according to what our reading says this morning. Number one, we've been saved from Satan's chains. Brother, he has his yoke upon this world today. People are flocking toward the call of the devil this morning. They're caught up in the things of this world. They're caught up in alcoholism. They're caught up in drugs. They're caught up in the lusts of the flesh. They're caught up in all these things. And Satan has them shackled by all of those things. This man was shackled by Satan's chains. Everyone here is or has been shackled by Satan's chains. But if you're a born-again believer in Jesus Christ this morning, if you've been saved by God's grace today, Satan no longer has power over you.
Amen.
No longer does he have power over you. I don't need Satan's chains this morning on me anymore. You say, what kind of chains does he put on you? Number one, he puts the chain of spiritual defeat on you. I don't need to be defeated. Brother, I can't be defeated, as a matter of fact, because Philippians, a familiar scripture, if you're a churchgoer or not, this one's familiar, they use it all the time. Philippians 4:13 says, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. I am not shackled by Satan's chain of defeat this morning. I cannot be defeated. There's no weapon formed against me that will prosper this morning because Jesus Christ is a part of my life.
Amen.
There's no chains needed. The devil might as well not even bring the chain of defeat and try to put it upon me because Jesus Christ set me free when I accepted Him as my Savior. Brother, all I had to do was believe that He died on a cross and He was buried and rose again the third day. That's all that it takes this morning is a belief on Jesus Christ. We can defeat the devil this morning.
Amen. That's right.
That chain of defeat. There's no chain needed this morning.
That's right.
The Lord broke that chain. when he came out of the grave on that Easter Sunday morning, what we call Easter, on that third Sunday morning, when he came out of the grave victorious over death and hell and Satan's ways. Do not this morning, if you're a believer in Jesus Christ, do not allow the devil to throw his chain of defeat on you. Just shake it off.
Amen.
And make the devil take it back. Second thing this morning, Satan's chain of the lust of the flesh. Brother, that chain's not needed.
Amen.
We were talking about it on the way home. My mother-in-law, I talked to her, believe it or not. On the way home on Thursday night, we were talking about how that as a Christian, we can do whatever we want to do. You know I can. Oh, I got your attention now, didn't I? I got your attention now. Brother, I can do whatever I want to do. Brother, I want to serve the Lord.
Amen.
I want to read my Bible.
Amen.
I want to pray to the Lord and call on His name for my needs. When sickness comes, I want to call on the Lord because I know He's a healer of the sick. Brother, when trouble comes, I want to call on the Lord because I know He's a rescuer in the valley of the shadow of death. I want to go to church. I want to sit in the old-fashioned church pew. I want to sing the songs of Zion. I want to know more about the Lord so I can do what I want to do.
Right.
See, my want to's changed. I don't want to do what I used to do. I have no desire. There's no eternity in the things of this world. Everything you see around you is temporary.
That's right.
Look around you this morning. Look at the person next to you. Look at this building, the wood, the bricks, the drywall, the people sitting next to you. Look at your hand. Look at your face. Get your mirror out. Whatever you see right now is temporary. It's short term. Why would we want to get involved in short term? Why would we want to get involved in the temporary things when the Lord has given us the eternal things that we can grab hold of, that we can hold on to? As I preached to you last Sunday morning, the Word of God shall stand forever. Why not believe on God's Word? Why not believe in a God that was there before time began and will be there after our time ends? Why not believe in that? Why not do the things that God wants us to do because He made us to do them? Everything else is temporary. Brother, the lust of the flesh. Brother, I'm still, the outward man is still human. But the Lord has put a spirit in me that when the lust of the flesh draw me, brother, that spirit says, don't. I don't have a desire to do those things anymore. So shake that chain off this morning. That chain's not needed anymore. The devil may throw temptation out in front of you as a believer, but the Bible says with every temptation, God makes a way of escape. There's a way out of temptation this morning by casting that chain off. No chain needed. Third thing this morning, fear. Brother, the devil will throw that chain of fear on you and make you afraid of what you're going through. Make you afraid of maybe an opportunity that the Lord has opened up for you. Make you afraid of what's going on in our world today. The Bible says perfect love casteth out all fear.
That's right.
Where does perfect love come from? Not from us. Brother, our perfect love is identified in a Hallmark card on Valentine's Day. Well, that's perfect. If it's got a little red heart and it's Valentine's Day or your anniversary or your wife or husband's birthday, oh, you just love them to death, don't you? I'm going to buy them a card. I don't know what to say, but man, this card says exactly what I wanted to say. There's a couple things in there that I'm not sure that I mean, but I should, probably shouldn't scribble them out. I'll give it to them anyways. That's what we consider as love. We don't understand love, but Jesus Christ loved us before we knew what love was. While we were yet sinners, He died on a cross. And all we have to do is grab hold of the Lord as He grabs hold of us, shake that chain of fear off, and believe on His name. There's no need to fear this morning what's going on around you.
Amen.
No chain needed. Satan's got some chains, don't he? He's trying to bog us down. Oh, I don't feel good today. You know what? Your pastor got up at 9:05 this morning. And I looked at my clock. I got this Christian song plays on my phone on Sunday morning to wake me up. It's an alarm that goes off. Every other day it's, oh, you got to go to work. But on Sunday morning, I got this good Christian song that comes on at about 8:20, and I get up and I get ready. This morning, I was laying in bed, and I rolled over and picked my phone up and looked to see what time it was. It was 8:55. I said to Karen, "It's 8:55 already." Usually, we leave by 9 o'clock. I do a pretty good job in 5 minutes, don't I? Well, if it would have been left up to me, I thought on the way to church this morning, how long could I have slept if I would have just stayed in bed? We get so wrapped up in the things of this world, we're dependent on somebody else. I'm dependent on, I can't think of what his name is, that sings that song that's on my phone to wake me up on Sunday morning. We depend on other people to take care of us. But I had a want to go to church, and I had a want to, and I got up and I got ready, and this is the best it gets in 15 minutes.
That's fine.
Thank the Lord this morning that He's given me a desire, that He broke the chain that Satan had on me. Now it gets a little bit harder. There's other chains that's on us. Your chains that affect me. Do you know that you may have chains that try to affect, and I may have chains that try to affect you. We can't let them. There's no chains needed in this walk.
That's right.
Your fear of me. Say, what do you mean? Look at what the scripture says here in verse number 15 of our reading. In verse number 15. Now this man had been healed. The Bible says, and the Lord had cast these demons out. It says, and they come to Jesus and see him, the man who was possessed with the devil, and had the legion sitting and clothed in his right mind, and they were afraid. They were afraid of this man. Now, here he had been for several years running around this graveyard naked, cutting himself with stones and breaking these chains loose from himself. And the Bible says here he was now completely different, sitting in his right mind. He was clothed, and they were afraid of him. You know, there's times in our lives as Christians that we fear our brothers and sisters in Christ. We're afraid that they may be closer to the Lord than we are. We're afraid that maybe that they can look at you and see the fault that's in you. I can't let your chains bind me. Don't let my chains bind you. I'll say this morning to you. I told my boss at work just back in my review. I said, I'm not afraid of you. Brother, I'm not afraid of you this morning.
That's right.
I'm not afraid that what you're doing is going to affect me. Well, don't be afraid of me. I know I get up here sometimes and I get all wound up and I run around the pulpit here and I act crazy. Some people might think, don't be afraid, just jump on board. Brother, we fear that somebody may be getting a blessing when we're not. We fear that maybe somebody's closer to the Lord than we are. Brother, don't be afraid of it. Just move up closer. Don't be afraid of the Spirit of God as it works on one of your brothers and they hold their hand up and praise the Lord. Brother, raise your hand too and praise Him right along with them. Your chain of unforgiveness, don't let it bind me. Don't let my chain of unforgiveness bind you. We talked about this on Thursday night a little bit. Brother, the Bible gives us a distinct guideline as to how to work out offenses between us and our brothers and sisters in Christ. If I've gone through that process that the Bible gives me, you've done something that's hurt me, or I've done something that hurt you, and I come to you and say, forgive me, and you're unwilling to forgive me, the Bible teaches me to just shake the dust off my feet and keep on serving the Lord.
That's right.
Brother, there's people who have been in church, and again, talked about it on Thursday, I preached part of my message Thursday night. There's been people that's gone to church and they got hurt because somebody said something that they didn't like, or the preacher didn't go along with what they thought, and they quit going to church and they're sitting. There's somebody this morning when 8:55 rolled around, they just rolled over and went back to sleep because they got hurt 15 years ago and they're not going to church anymore. You know what happens? Brother, God's train keeps on rolling.
That's right.
Brother, the Lord's still chugging along while we're pouting and while we're complaining and while we're having a pity party for ourselves because we don't like somebody or somebody don't like us. The Lord's train's still chugging along and brother, we're sitting still while God's people are moving forward. I can't let your unforgiveness affect me, and you can't let mine affect you. We need to just keep on keeping on for the Lord and realize that in this world we're all in a fleshly body. Brother, and sometimes we're going to hurt each other. Sometimes we're going to say things we don't like. Brother, I may have said something already this morning in the message that you didn't like. Well, praise the Lord. Just keep on keeping on for Him. We got too many people as Christians. You say, I didn't come to hear this. That's all right. I'm going to say it anyways. But we got too many Christians that's wearing their Christian feelings on their shirt sleeve. And every time something happens, they get hurt over it. Well, we can't be like that. Think of Jesus. The God, what we're learning on Thursday night. Jesus was God in the flesh. He came into this world, God. And you know what they did to Him? They spit in His face. They slapped Him in the face. They plucked out His beard. They put a crown of thorns on His head. They hung Him on a cross. You know what He did? He kept on doing what He came to do. The Bible says that He was led as a lamb to the slaughter and He opened not His mouth. He willingly gave His life for us. While we sit back and complain about Him, He's hearing every prayer we send up. He's listening to all of our problems. He knows exactly where we're at right now. He's got a plan for you tomorrow.
Amen.
That you'll stand in awe of what He's done. I can't let your chains affect me, and don't let mine affect you. And then there's my chain. Those things that I allow me to be overcome by. Those chains that you allow yourself to be overcome by. There's no chains needed as a believer in Christ. Shake him. Well, here's this man. You talk about somebody in chains. This man was in chains. You talk about somebody that understood what being bound up was. He understood it. But on this day, the Bible says that he was clothed in his right mind and sitting at the feet of Jesus. My chains, when it comes to my service for the Lord, is my ideas. I got a lot of good ideas that God needs to listen to. Don't you? But there's times I just think, Lord, this is a good one. You need to hear this one. Lord, why don't you do things this way? Lord, why don't you do things that way? You know what that is? That's a chain. It's holding me back. Because this is about God. This is not about me. This is about God. This is not about you. This is about God. This is not about Alpine Valley Church. Brother, we're on God's train. God's not on mine. They sang about the long black train. Brother, the devil's riding the long black train. Brother, we need to get on board with the Lord, not ask the Lord to get on board with us. Why don't you do things the way I want them done, Lord? The Bible says that he was there before beginning. Before there was a beginning, he was there. He doesn't need my opinion now. He doesn't need my idea now. But it does hold me back. There's times when my ideas in my spiritual life hold me back. Especially as a preacher. Especially as a pastor. Brother, I question the Lord. Lord, why aren't you doing this? Lord, why aren't you doing that? And there's times when he says, you don't understand. It's those times when the Lord says, you don't understand, when I sit back and take notice. Because God, I see things like this. God sees things like this. God sees the big picture while I'm looking through my blinders. And I just see what's right in front of me. Brother, that chain needs to be shook off. My imperfections, they hold me back. Those chains of my imperfections. I know you have a hard time believing it, but I have some. I spent a few years trying to convince Karen that I didn't have any imperfections. And then we got married. And I've been spending the last 25 years trying to convince her that I do have some. Brother, my imperfections hold me back as a Christian a lot of times. Because I know I have faults. Especially if I'm watching somebody else. I like listening to preachers. And I know you're thinking I'm tired of listening to one right now. But I like listening to them. And I'll watch YouTube videos of preachers. And I'll listen to preachers on the radio. And I like getting different thoughts and different ideas about different Bible topics. But there's a whole lot of them that preach, and I think, man, I wish I could preach like they do. I wish that I had that knowledge that they have, or I wish I had that spirit that they have, or I wish that I could present things like they do. But God didn't call me to be them.
That's right. Amen.
God didn't call me to be Billy Graham. God didn't call me to be Jimmy Swaggart, praise the Lord. God didn't call me to be any of those preachers. God called me to be me.
That's right. Yeah.
And I have imperfections, and they hold me back. They keep me from a lot of times. I always thought when the Lord called me to preach, Lord, why would you call me? I'm afraid to talk in front of people. Never was good at it. Still aren't. Aren't. Still ain't. Still one of those things. Not good at it. Just not good at it. It's one of my imperfections. But here's God's train. It's moving forward. Neither I need to get on board and realize that I am who I am. And remember what Paul said, I am what I am by the grace of God. I am what I am. I have imperfections. I have flaws. I have problems. And I can't let those chains weigh me down. I need to just shake them off.
Right.
Say, Lord, here I am. Use me just the way I am. And the last thing this morning as we close. Those chains of my past.
That's right.
The devil brings up my past a lot. No chain needed. I don't need those. Those things are under the blood. The Lord forgave me of all those things. It's behind me. I don't need the devil bringing them up anymore. I don't need to bring them up anymore. I don't need that chain anymore. I need to just shake it off. Because the Lord, the Bible says it. He takes our sin and He puts them in a bag and He seals it up. Never to be opened again. It also says in there that He casts it as far as the east is from the west.
Amen.
There's people that will bring up my past. Well, I know what you used to be. Well, let me tell you this. I'm not what I necessarily want to be. I'm not always what God wants me to be. But thank God I'm not what I used to be.
Amen.
You see, I got a vision of what's in front of me now.
Yeah.
Nothing to look back to. Well, I'm closer. I got more years behind me than I got in front. Amen. I'm closer home today than I was yesterday, than I was 20 years ago. Well, I got a past that is running quickly behind me, but I got a future that I'm going to catch up to before my past catches up to me. Brother, that chain, there's no chains needed. This man, he had all those things. Bible says that they were afraid of him. They were unforgiving of this man. They told the Lord, said, just send him away. Get him out of here. We don't want him around. We know what he used to be. We know what he was. We know what he's capable of. Here he sat, clothed in his right mind, right next to Jesus. And all they could see were the chains. But the chains weren't even on him. The chains weren't even on him. He had broke free.
Amen.
This morning, if you know the Lord as your Savior, there's no chains on you.
Amen.
No, don't try to. Don't put them on yourself. Don't let somebody else put them on you. Don't let the devil try to put them on you. There's no chains needed. This man, they didn't need no chains anymore. But man, they sure did have a lot of chains they wanted to put on him, didn't they? Stand with me this morning. Let's sing a verse of
I believe in a hill called Mount.